In this segment, we're going to talk about the pons. The pons, quite literally, is Latin for bridge. So if you're ever going to Italy and you see the Ponte whatever, it's the bridge over the whatever. So pons means bridge, and it is in between the medulla down here, medulla oblongata, and then pons, and then the midbrains above it. You can see it on a cross-section here. So the pons has some very specific features. And these include the pontine fibers, which you can actually kind of see on the surface, big bundles of fibers going across the pons. Another prominent feature of the pons is the middle cerebellar peduncle, which you can see right here going into the cerebellum. And the pons forms the floor of the fourth ventricle, as you can see here. Here's our fourth ventricle, with the cerebellum being on the roof and the pons being on the floor. If you take a cross-section through the pons, again, you can see the middle cerebellar peduncle and the fourth ventricle. And again, all of these pontine fibers are going all over the place in here. There are four cranial nerves also associated with the pons, and these include the trigeminal, which we can't really see on the actual brainstem, but I can point them out over here on the rubber brainstem. The fifth cranial nerve is here. The sixth cranial nerve is here. The sixth cranial nerve is the abducens. The fifth is the trigeminal. And then seven and eight are in here, with eight being this kind of bigger one here because it's got two components, and then the smaller seventh cranial nerve. So these four cranial nerves, 5, 6, 7, and 8, are associated with the pons. And again, I'll talk more about the details of these individual cranial nerves later in the series of lectures involving the brainstem and cranial nerves. In the next segment, we'll talk all about the midbrain.